This game a bit different from last year when you were in the same situation, just missed the playoffs, playing it. Can you just tell me?
Yeah, I mean, it has been different. We're going to the, last year in the Sugar Bowl, this year going the same thing, just like you said. Coach Smart and the older guys on the team have done a great job of just kind of changing things up a little bit. Coach Smart was saying practice is a little shorter, an hour and a half, we're getting after it. Being competitive, and practices are fun and fast, and I think this team's a lot more excited to play in this game, and so we're going to be ready to play Baylor, and they're a really good team.
When you look at it retrospectively, do you think attitude and motivation had anything to do with you guys losing to Texas last year?
I think it can play into it, definitely, but it's hard to – I don't want to dwell on the past, because this team really has worked their butt off this season, and especially in this bowl practice right now, so we're excited to play in this game.
What's Kirby done on campus to keep the focus on, the guys that are on the strip and are eligible to play versus guys that maybe chose on their own or just, for one reason or another can't play? Has he done anything to make the focus inward and not on those guys that aren't necessarily lining up for you guys?
Yeah, those guys with their decisions, it's great for them. They're moving on to the next level, and the guys with injuries and stuff like that. But this team just bought into, just going out there and playing the game, playing for each other, and playing, just to win a ball game. So we all want to win, and we all want to go have fun, and in the Sugar Bowl is a great opportunity. It's an honor to play in this bowl.
At the same time, y'all were a win away from being in the playoffs, which, if y'all had won, you'd be in Atlanta right now, just like LSU and Oklahoma. How much does that eat at you? Hey, we were that close, didn't make it.
Yeah, it'll eat at you a little bit, but you can't let it bother you more than 24 hours after that, after losing to LSU. Because what happens. LSU is a really good football team, and I think this team, we prepared as well as we could have for that game. We put ourselves in the best position possible, but we didn't get the outcome we wanted, and we didn't reach all the goals that we wanted to the season. But you got to move on and prepare for the next game. And we've enjoyed practices, and we're ready to play Baylor.
How do you keep this from being kind of the same old you guys were just here a year ago and did probably some of the same little activities? Is there anything to kind of do you care about keeping it fresh or something different or in terms of the game week?
Yeah, definitely. We are. I'm assuming we'll talk probably to us, a few of the same things. But really, I think this team, we're still excited to come here, to come to New Orleans, come do some things, especially the freshmen, it's a big new thing for them. But even the guys that came here last year, definitely a little bit of, nostalgia, if that's the word. But at the end of the day, we are excited. It has been really fun postseason practices, compared to what it could have been.
You're going to have new tackles beside you at the very least. What does that look like? How do you see, Cade and Jamari and the other guys being able to fill in for what Andrew and Isaiah do?
Yeah, definitely. Cade and Jamari have done really well. They've done really well all season, and they've done really well in this bowl practice playing tackle. And it's been fun to, because we're always lined up next to them, it's been fun to, to kind of learn how they play and to play with them these last few practices. And I'm excited to watch them play because they're really good football players, and it's going to be fun.
If you bulked up, you can be playing offensive.